What's up, YouTube? So, Apple released its iOS 10 beta 6 to developers. If you're on the public beta, that would be beta 5. And you're probably wondering what changed and what's new. I haven't actually covered the betas that much this time, but since we're on beta 6, I wanted to jump back and show you guys what's new and what's available. So in this release, personally, there wasn't anything real showstopper. So we're not seeing any modified or changes. The control center still seems to be the same. We're still seeing the same animations. But the one thing I did notice that not a lot of people are talking about is the overall stability of iOS 10 has greatly improved with the beta 6. And I'm pretty excited for that because up until now, I haven't really been using the iOS 10 just because it was in low beta, almost what I would consider an alpha, just with the bugs and glitches that I ran into. Now, I did notice a few things. So moving around, the animations to me, and some of you may say different, seem to be sped up a little bit in this beta, as well as I wasn't able to move my card up and down in the last beta. I don't know if that was a glitch on my device, but I did notice on beta 6 that I am now able to do that. That is really the only change that I was able to find in this beta. Although in beta 5, we did get a new lock sound, which you guys heard there. And then on the home screen too, lock screen, I just noticed the widgets also load and refresh a lot quicker. Now, Apple did quote a couple changes in this beta on their developer website. One being that search will now function as expected in the Messenger store. So if you were searching in the Messenger store and it just was not working whatsoever, that function should now work for you. Now that should be with the stickers and stuff when you go in here. Unfortunately, this device is just it's blank right now, so I don't have anything to show you guys, so it won't let me open them up. Another thing that they said they improved was Siri. So Siri will now recognize that you have removed a stock application. So if we go to remove, say, stocks, and if we ask Siri now to show us a stock, hey Siri, what's Apple's stock price? So you can see it actually provides the proper response where before the application, if you removed it, wouldn't respond whatsoever. Siri kind of got confused. That's not an app. So those were kind of the big changes. They also fixed a few things with the stickers. Again, I did notice a slight improvement. I am on the iPhone 5 here with this. And yeah, so make sure you guys like this video, subscribe to the channel for more iOS 10 videos. As the betas come closer to launch here in September, I will start to cover them a lot more heavily. So we'll see you guys then. Cheers.